This is an RODI filter. Dirty tap water goes in here, and clean filter water comes out here. RODI stands for reverse osmosis deionization. RODI systems are used for making salt water and replacing evaporated tank water. Every beginner needs an RODI filter. Here's how an RODI filter works. This end attaches to an indoor faucet or an outdoor spigot. The first chamber houses a sediment filter. It removes anything that might be floating in the water, just like a sponge filter or a filter sock. In the next chamber, activated carbon removes chemicals, odors, and colors from the water, things like chlorine, pesticides, and chloramines. Activated carbon is so porous that 0.14 ounces, less than the weight of a first-class letter, contains as much surface area as an entire football field. And it is all those pores that trap the chemicals and remove them from your tap water. The next chamber, or chambers, contain your reverse osmosis membrane. It's a semi-permeable plastic-like sheet that is rolled up tight. Using the water pressure from your tap, the smaller water molecules are forced through that semi-permeable RO membrane, while the larger contaminants like salts, heavy metals, and a ton of different chemicals can't pass through. All of the clean water enters the final filtration chamber, and all of the dirty water exits from the black RO tubing here. The final stage contains deionization resin, which are ionically charged microplastic beads. These resins remove any remaining ions from the water, leaving completely purified H2O. Every beginner should have an RODI filter. Here are your options for filling your tank with salt water and replacing evaporated water. First is to get it directly from the ocean. Most of us don't live on the ocean, and for those of us who do, it is a huge pain. The water may be contaminated and it may be illegal in your area to do so. Option number two is to buy pre-made salt water from your local fish store. At $1 per gallon, it will cost you over $400 per year plus gas and labor transporting the water back and forth for a 70-gallon tank. Option number three is to buy distilled water from your grocery store. It's expensive and you'll be lugging a lot of 1-gallon jugs home. Option number four, just use tap water. While there are a small minority of hobbyists who can get away with it, you will probably experience long-term negative consequences, and we do not recommend doing this. Option number five is to buy RODI water from your local fish store, and at 50 cents a gallon, you'll pay over $200 a year when making it at home will cost you under $10 a year. Option number six, just buy an RODI filter. For a one-time purchase, you'll be able to make all of the water you need for a 70-gallon aquarium for well under $10 a year. Choosing the right RODI filter does not have to be complicated. All RODI filters have the same four core elements: a sediment filter, a carbon filter, a reverse osmosis filter, and DI resin. But there are add-ons that can increase your clean water output, reduce waste, increase your water pressure, inform you when it's time to change your filters, or just beef up the overall filtration. The beauty of RODI filter systems is they are completely upgradable, so you can start with a less expensive, more simple RODI filter, and then purchase add-ons over time as your situation requires. Is your RODI filter producing water too slowly? Get a pressure gauge to check the water pressure and or add a second RO membrane. Low water pressure? Add a booster pump. Too many chlorines and chloramines in your tap water? Add a second carbon chamber. For your first RODI filter, just start with a four-stage system. There are three great beginner options for your first RODI filter. You could choose the four-stage value plus 150 gallon per day system, or if you don't want the inline TDS meter or pressure gauge, purchase the four-stage value 150 gallon per day RODI system, or for the least expensive and pared down version, the four-stage value 75 gallon per day works just fine. We'll put links below to all three of those options, but whichever you choose, setup is super easy. The red line goes into the water source, the black line goes into the drain, and the blue line is the clean water that goes into a bucket or trash can for collection. To install on a kitchen or bathroom faucet, use the faucet diverter valve and adapter kit as necessary. Remove the mesh filter from the faucet and screw on the diverter valve. Unscrew the compression nut and slide it over the red tubing. Push the red RO tubing securely over the barbed output and screw the compression nut back into place. To remove RO tubing from any push connect fitting, hold the retention ring tightly against the fitting on both sides and pull the tubing out. Connecting to a utility sink or a hose spigot is even easier. Just screw on the hose adapter and insert the RO tubing into the push fitting. The only thing easier than setting up the RODI filter is operating it. If your filter comes with a flush valve, place it in the parallel open position. Turn on the water and
let it flush out the RO membrane for 1 to 2 minutes. Then turn the flush valve to the perpendicular close position. Flushing the RO membrane before and after use will get rid of a lot of heavy metals and prolong the membrane life. Be sure to set a timer as a reminder to turn off the system, or you could end up with a huge puddle of water on the floor. Before turning off the water flow, be sure to turn that flush valve back to the parallel open position and flush for 1 to 2 minutes. You've made a few batches of water and it's just not performing how you thought it would. Is it already time to change out the filters? In fact, you are probably making one of these super common mistakes that could reduce your total water output by half. Find out if you're doing something wrong by watching this video right here. And as always, everyone, thanks for watching. Happy reefing, be well. We'll see you next time.